Now, can you tell me on this Oracle site which download should I take out of these three?
JDK.
JDK, right. JDK. So let's click JDK. Now I talked about that Java was made platform independent. That when we are downloading this, they have done development for all these platforms. Just so that we don't have to worry about that we are writing code on one platform, how it will run on other platforms. So since JDK contains JRE, we have to tell which JVM or which JRE gets installed on our machine. So out of these, we have to install something. If I am on, since I am on Windows OS, I have only two choices which are confusing right now, which one I should go ahead with. Then on Linux, there are multiple choices. On Mac, there is only one choice. Is there anyone who is taking the training who uses Linux? Okay, I'll treat silence as no, that nobody is using Linux. So if people are using Mac, then it's clear that there's only one installer. And if people are using Windows, there is some confusion that which one we should take. Answer to that confusion is, you can go to properties of your machine, this PC, go to properties, and here it will be written our system type. And my system type, it says, is 64-bit operating system. So if we are using a 64-bit operating system, then we have to go with x64. Other option that you will see is, some machines you will see 32-bit operating system. If it is 32-bit, then you have to go with the x86 version, which is 32-bit version. So that is just the distinction. We should know which OS we are at, and according to that, we just download and install. And in order to download this, we'll first have to accept this license agreement. If I just click here, it will say you have not accepted the license agreement. We just click this. Once that is accepted, we can start downloading. Now, just to save time, before the class, I downloaded it because it's a 200 MB download. So I have it available in my downloads. If you see, this was installed, I think, 2 hours back. Now I have it downloaded. I'll go and install it. So I double click, say yes, and see, we are installing JDK. So the installation will begin. And when we are installing JDK, we can see that it is bringing in the JRE also. There are development tools, there is source code, and there is JRE. Reason the source code is available is Java is open source. So along with that, source code also of the main libraries of Java, they ship. So but ultimately, the distinction or the thing that I had drawn here, I said JDK is nothing but JRE plus compilers. Here they are saying it's JRE plus some other development tools. So along with compiler, there are some other things. So let's go ahead next. And it will take its own time to get installed. Now once this is installed, we will be in a position to write our programs, compile our programs, and run our programs. Now two commands we should be aware of. I mean, these things are something that we will not need going forward, but we should know that there are two steps we want to do. First step is write code in Java. After that, compile our code. So three steps, sorry. Third is run code. And when we say run code, that is bytecode. When we say compile code, we are compiling our Java code. And when we are writing the code, that also we are writing in Java. So these three steps are something that we are going to see once the Java gets installed. So installation is still going on. And once the installation completes, in the same command prompt which I opened earlier to check Java is installed or not, if I go and write Java, it will not work. Because after the installation is done, we'll have to open another command prompt in order to validate that Java is installed. So once this installer goes off, I'll close this command prompt and I'll relaunch it. Yeah. So now Java is installed. So I'll open the new command prompt. Here if I go and say Java minus version, and now you say it, this computer tells that you have Java this version installed, runtime is this version, hotspot, it is 64-bit server. That's what we saw, that there was 64 and 32-bit versions. So now Java got installed, and we have specially installed JDK. So when we install JDK, we'll get command javac, and here we can write program name dot java. This is what, how we will compile our code. When we run our code, we will write java program name, that's it. So this is, here it's program name dot java, complete file name. Here it is just the java and our program name, not the complete file name. Dot java is not to be given.